shout out to him. Since the United States Corporation, 28 U.S.C. 3002, subsection 15A, went bankrupt in 1933, all new money has to be borrowed into existence. I need you guys to listen well, because you're going to comprehend why you have to be a secure party creditor, and you need to stop listening to these people that are telling you that you don't, because they don't understand it. Show them this video. They can't come against me. Tell them to prove me wrong, man. None of these guys are nowhere as near knowledgeable as me on this particular topic, man. Most of the stuff that they talk to, man, I'll shut all of these people down, man. They're not even close to me, man. I look at this and I find loopholes in all of the garbage that they're pushing to you people. So I'm going to give you right knowledge for real. So the United States went into bankruptcy in 1933, and all new money has to be borrowed into existence. All states started issuing serial numbered certified warehouse receipts. I want you to go and check out everything I'm saying. All states started issuing serial numbered certified warehouse receipts for birth and marriages. Why? To pledge the people as collaterals against those loans and those municipal bonds taken out with the Federal Reserve banks. Now, if they did this, you can't undo this with consumer credit. How do you undo it? You undo it by becoming a secure party creditor and putting these agencies on notice. That's how you undo it, and that's the only way to do it. You can't undo it by becoming a moron, changing your name, claiming nationality. That's good, but it doesn't undo these contracts. The full faith and credit of the American people is said to be that which backs the national debt. Remember that. That simply means the American people's ability to labor and to pay back the debt. Well, so in order to catalog as laboring, the de facto government, right? Y'all caught that, right? Needed an efficient methodological system of tracking its property to that particular end. People today are looked upon merely as resources. They call you humans. And if you want a job or just over broke, you go to the human resources department, because you are a human resource. Human resources, that is. Well, so what do you think? When you call to see if a company is hiring, you have to go through a division known as what? Human resources. Consumer credit don't get you out of that. Human resources. The people are resources to the de facto. Their birth certificates or a security on the New York Stock Exchange. And I'm going to show you. I'm going to prove it. Because I'm going to take you to fidelity.com and show you how to look yours up. And I'm going to shut all of the nonsense down once and for all. You have to be a secure party creditor to get out of this, man. It is imperative. This is why, if you look at the birth certificate in America, it will say at the bottom, this is printed on security paper. Why? Why, Jonah Bay? Why, Monsa? Why is it printed on security paper? And it also says, do not accept if not on full color security paper. Why? Talk back to me. At the bottom, you will always have a series of numbers, sometimes in red on the older birth certificates. Sometimes it's on the back, printed on the birth certificate. in which those numbers are a security stock exchange number on the world stock exchange. In which American people are worth money in international bank that brought the government in the 1930s. Prove me wrong. I'll wait. The de facto assignment of a dollar value to the heads of citizens in America began on July. Write this down and go and check it out for yourself. July the 14th, 1862, when President Abraham Lincoln offered 6% interest hearing bonds to states who freed their slaves on a per head basis. Don't believe me? Go and check it out for yourself. Let's get some donations in the room, man. Pay me for my time and energy and research. See, the government knows that they could only extract as much fiat out of the economy. So the idea is to bankrupt private owners so that the banks who are behind this syndicate becomes the owners of all the assets in this country and throughout the world. That's the real scheme. I ain't no damn schemer. That's the real scheme. Motive. See, by encouraging Congress to spend money that it doesn't have, the Congress has to turn around and lean, L-I-E-N, on the American labor and the American private property for collateral. Consumer credit don't get you out of this, man. Nor does that more science nonsense. So a lot of them trying to take on this process, but they don't understand it. See, they do that by fraudulently conversions of birth certificates. Case in point, doctors who are franchisees of the state or obliged to sign birth certificates and forward them to the Secretary of State. Now, you tell me why they do that, Jonah Bay. Monster, if you don't have to be a secure party creditor, why does doctors have to do that? They make the certified copies and forward those birth certificates to the Department of Commerce in Washington, D.C. Don't believe me? Check it out for yourself. So the Department of Commerce does the same thing. They make certified copies and forward them onto the IMF, the International Monetary Fund in Brussels, Belgium. Now this is a center of the hub of the banking syndicate. And they, of course, loaning those huge sums to various governments around the world, including the Congress of the United States. The Congress needs something for collateral. And what they use for collateral are those birth certificates. Understand that. So consumer credit don't get you out of that, boy. See, these birth certificates get treated as certificates in equity, which mature on the 18th birthday of the person whose names appear on the birth certificate, the legal age of majority. The bank then keeps track of those and use those numbers that any particular nation has available as collateral on the international debt as performance units on the international debt. These certificates in equity end up being regarded as performance units on the international debt. See, the more of those you have, the more money you could borrow. Excuse me. It's like this, folks. Watch this. Watch this. The more collateral I have, the more money I could borrow from the banks and the more I can secure. So the de factos are securing their international debt by, listen, folks, listen, by listening on the persons and property of their citizens. They're doing this on a massive scale. And it's technically fraudulent conversions of both the birth certificates. Now, if they did that with your birth certificate and they never told you what they was doing, they never told you they were actually obtaining a lien on your person and starting a third-party debt that you're responsible for. Consumer credit don't get you out of this, man. More science don't get you out of this. Being a secure party creditor does. You're going to find out today, man. Your bond's been all over the stock market. See, the thing is, folks, we had no meaningful choice in the matter, which makes it unconscionable contracts. That's an unconscionable contract. See, by definition, it's an unconscionable contract. So let's go to 1921. The Federal Shepherd-Turner Maternity Act created the birth registration, or what we know today as the birth certificate. Write that down and go and look it up. Then give it to this guy, Jonah Bay and Monson, and all these people to send secure party credit process is not necessary. And maybe they will wake up. See, you have no meaningful choice in the matter, which make it an unconscionable contract. This was known as the Maternity Act. And it was sold to the American people as law that will reduce the maternal and infant mortality and protect the health of the mothers and the infants. And it was used for that purpose and other purposes. Now, one of those other purposes provided the establishment of federal bureau designed to cooperate with state agencies in the overseeing of this operations and expenditures. So what it really did was create federal birth registries, which exists today. What did that do? That created federal children. See, the de facto under the doctrine of parens parente now legislates for American children's as if they are owned by the federal government. And through the public school system enrollment process and containing license requirements for most aspects of daily life, the children grow up to be adults indoctrinated into the process of asking for permission from the de facto that's posing as God to do all things necessary to carry out daily activities that exist in what is called a free country. How can it be free if you need to ask for permission to have a weapon? How can it be free if you need to ask for permission to drive? Before 1921, the record of births and names of children were entered into the family Bibles, as were recorded records of marriages and deaths. It was all recorded in the family Bible, and that was considered a legal document and still is. These records was readily accepted by both families and the law as official records. Now, since 1921, the American people have been registering their births. They've been registering the names of their children with the government of the state in which they are born. Stop me where I'm lying at. Even though there is no federal law requiring it. Show me the law that requires it. See, the state tells you that registering your children's birth through the birth certificate serves as proof that he or she was born in the United States, thereby making him or her a United States citizen. Now, for the past several years, a Social Security number has been mandated by the federal government to be issued at birth. Stop me where I'm lying at. In 1933, the bankruptcy was declared by President Franklin Delano Roosevelt. The governors of then 48 states at that particular time pledged the full faith and credit of their states, including the citizens, as collateral for loans of credit from the Federal Reserve System. Full faith and credit clause of the Constitution of the United States, Article 4, Section 1, requires that foreign judgments be given such faith and credit as had by law or usage of state of its origin. So foreign status are to have force and effects to which they are actually entitled in the home state. And that a judgment or record shall have the same faith, credit, and conclusive effect and obligatory force in other states as it has by law or usage in the state from which it was taken. So the state claims an entrance in every child within its jurisdiction. State has an interest in you. So the state will, if deemed it necessary, nullify your parental rights and appoint a guardian, which is a trustee, well, over your children. Some of you seen this done through CPS, well, DFC, DFS, whatever it's called in your state, well. See, the subject of every birth certificate is what? The child. The child. The child is a valuable asset. I'll say that again. The child is a valuable asset, which, if properly trained, can contribute valuable assets provided by its labor for many years. Why do you think they teach teachers to not only teach their students, but also their parents, that the child needs a good education so that they could grow up and get a job? I mean, a job. I mean, a just over broke. All of you been taught that. They've been making the people slaves for years. And no one has ever stopped questioning them on it. So then you got people come along, oh, you don't have to be a Secure Party credit. Shut up and listen. See, the child itself, when born, is not an asset of the trust established by the birth certificate and the Social Security number, is the numbering or registration of the trust, allowing for the asset of the trust to be tracked, thus making whoever gets a birth certificate owned by the state. So you tell me how in the hell consumer credit, a bill of exchange, or anything gets you out of that. It doesn't get you out of that. The only process that gets you out of that is known as the redemption process, secure creditor process, that some refer to as secure party creditor, because you're securing your creditor, your party. Huh? Everyone who has a birth certificate are considered an asset of the bankrupt United States of America, which makes them designated by this government as human resources. Again, zero. Ask yourself, why do you think when you call to see if a company is hiring, that you go through a human resources department division? Why? See, today, we're defined as human resources, believed to be owned by the government. The government now wants us as individuals to be tagged and tracked. Government mandated or legislated national ID is unconstitutional, folks, any way that you look at it. Federal jurisdiction to the legislative for the several states does not exist. They have no legislations for ordering you to have any identification card. Understand that.